Okay, we are going to be doing 3-2 on the top and 3-3 on the bottom. They really go together because 3-2 is addition and subtraction. And 3-3 is multiplication and division. And I'm going to just do some examples of each with you guys before you are off to do your work. And all of this is basically solving inequalities by adding and subtracting or multiplying and dividing. So your homework for the weekend is going to include problems from both 3-2 and 3-3. And on Monday, I'll take any questions on 3-1, 3-2, 3-3, since we've kind of moved past 3-1's examples today. Gives you some time to catch up. We are going to start with x plus 12 is less than 20. The only difference between the kind of work we've been doing before and now is instead of an equal sign, we have an inequality symbol. Yep. All the rules are still the same. I see addition, so I'm going to do
subtraction.
Gonna subtract 12. And I get x is less than
8.
And then I'm gonna check. Remember all of these rules here. First, get the variable isolated. Check the order, is it on the left? Circle the number on the number line. Well, basically you have to make a number line and then circle it. You're going to be making lots of little number lines today. They just have to be a quick zoom in on the number line. Do not feel like you have to start at zero. What number are we going to be circling here?
Eight.
So I would probably have like 6, 7, 8, 9. It doesn't have to be very big. You can use your pen or pencil, or you can use a marker. I'm going to circle 8, that's what my step says. I'm going to ask myself, is this open or closed?
Open.
It's open. And I'm not shading because it's open, and I'm going to draw my arrow going to the
left.
What does that mean? Our graph is showing that every number lower than 8 makes this inequality true. I could put any number that's over here in for x, and it would be true. And that's it. Does this look pretty simple?
Yeah.
Okay. That's why we're doing 3-2 and 3-3 together. Okay, an example for subtraction. What if I start off with y minus 5 is greater than negative 7? I don't know why I'm suddenly writing in red. Oops. Okay, I see subtraction, so I do addition. Y is greater than negative 2. Snapshot of a zoomed in number line. This time I might want to put a 0 because it's close to it, isn't it? I don't think you should ever put more than like 5 numbers on your zoomed in number line. 3, 4, 5 numbers, that's all you really need to do. We're just showing where on the number line this point is going to fall. What number am I circling?
Negative.
Which direction is my arrow going to go?
Right.
Is my circle shaded in?
No.
He's trying to cover all the answers.
I mean, no.
Thumbs up if you feel like you can do problems like this.
Yes.
Even if they get a little bit more complex with some distribution or like all of the stuff we've been doing before works here. We just have a number line that's showing our answer instead of a specific number. Okay, and we have the golden rule, which we'll get to in our next examples. Because both of these are addition subtraction. Are we multiplying or dividing here?
No.
No, when we get to multiplying and dividing, that's when it gets a little bit more interesting. Okay, what if we have, I'm gonna do a couple examples here. Let's start off with 3x is greater than negative 27. I'm going to divide by what?
3.
Okay. Is my 3 positive or negative?
Positive.
Nothing happens with the symbol then. It's going to stay exactly as it is. 3 divided by 3 is 1. That gives us x. is greater than negative 9. Just because there's a negative there and we divided does not mean we flip the symbol. It's only if what we divided by is negative. Okay? Zoom in on my number line. Let's see, I need negative 10, negative 9, negative 8. I really don't need a huge number line. Make it simple, guys. Circle the negative 9. It's greater than empty circle and going to the
right.
Okay. You might also have a division problem that would look like this. 2/3 y is less than 6. Why is it a division problem? Because it's a fraction and every fraction is a division problem. What's the opposite of 2/3? Because we want the number in front of this y to be a positive invisible 1. So we're going to multiply both sides by 3 over 2. We're going to get y is less than 18 divided by 2 is. And now I'm going to zoom in on the other side. 8, 9, 10. That symbol looks really weird. Try to make it clearer. I'm going to circle my 9, keeping it open. All of these examples were open. I'm sorry about that. And go to the left. We still haven't dealt with the golden rule, so we're going to do a couple more examples. Because this is where it really gets a little bit different from the subtracting or multiplying and dividing equations. What about if I have negative 12x is greater than 84? I'm not just dividing by 12, I'm going to divide by
negative 12.
Negative 12. And as soon as I see that I'm dividing by a negative 12, I want to rewrite my symbol down here, flipped. As soon as you divide or multiply by a negative, you want to flip your symbol. Because otherwise you forget and you just kind of continue with the math and you leave the symbol as it was. If you make that the very first thing you do, you won't forget. Okay, negative 12 divided by negative 12 gives us a positive invisible 1.
Negative 7.
And then I have 84 divided by negative 12 gives me
negative 7.
Zoom in on my number line. Negatives, I can even have that be my first number. Again, open circle to the left. This is where they start to look a little bit crazy. Last example I'm going to do with you guys, negative 8 is less than or equal to x divided by negative 3. Where is the x? It's being divided by a negative number. So we're going to have to multiply by a negative number. What negative number?
3.
Negative 3 over 1 times negative 3. I'm multiplying by a negative, so what happens to my symbol? I'm going to flip the symbol. I'm going to multiply a negative times a negative, and then I get a 24. And x. Now, what's wrong with this? I've taken care of simplifying it. I've got the x isolated on one side, but it's on the wrong side. So now I need to flip the whole thing. Right?
Oh, yes.
Because order matters, and we want the variable on the left because then the symbol is going the right direction for graphing. So this symbol is getting flipped again. Oops, I put 20. 24. Okay. Again, can you imagine if you had to make a number line from 0 to 24? You'd be here all day. All we need is 23, 24, 25. We're going to circle the 24. Open or closed?
Closed.
Finally, we get a closed circle, and it's going to the
left.
Okay. sense, we are going to go over the same problems together on Monday. I'm going to put these on the same page here. This was Thursday's homework right here.
The one I did.
That many of you may not have done yet. And here is Friday's homework. In 3-2, I'm just going to put down the page numbers. We're going to be on page 185, and we're also going to be on page 179. You guys are going to do numbers 1 through 4, 7 through 10. And then you're going to do numbers 1 through 16. And I think that'll be enough.
Yep.
Okay. We will go over, this is 3-1, this is 3-2, and this is 3-3. All of that is going to be due and ready to be reviewed on Monday, right?
Don't
forget to subscribe.
This is not really that many problems. The problem is that we were behind and didn't get enough of this done yesterday, right?
Don't forget to subscribe.